Listen up, you sorry lot. Gather round. We're handing out assignments today.
Gared, we'll be men of the watch before nightfall.
Right. Sorry. No hard feelings over that business with Finn, yeah? I appreciate you not ratting me out over the knife. It's nice to know there's at least one brother I can trust.
Just promise me you'll stop stealing things, Cutter.
All right. I swear it. Never again. Well, no guarantees on potatoes or lamprey pie. Or for that matter. Just messing with you, Gared. I promise. I'll mend my thieving ways.
Well, aren't you two sons of whores looking thick as thieves? Having a good laugh over nicking my knife, eh, Gared? Men like you turn traitor for nothing. It's in your blood.
Next, you'll be killing men of the watch for a loaf of bread.
I didn't take anything from you.
No, but you protected the bastard who did. You'll always be an asshole, Gared.
Oh, would you let it go? I've had enough of your shit, Finn.
Fuck off, Gared.
Finn, leave him alone. It wasn't Gared's fault. If you're gonna hate someone, hate me.
With pleasure.
Now, it doesn't matter what the world once called you. After today, you're all brothers. Could even be that the man standing next to you saves your life one day. Or maybe you'll save his.
Let's find out then, shall we? Casper, to the builders. Finn, to the rangers.
Eric, to the stewards. Hugh, to the rangers.
Cotter, to the builders.
And finally, Gared to the rangers. That's it. May all the gods preserve you.
Well, there we are. I'll be patching up the wall, and you'll be defending it.
Should you northern boys want your gods to give a blessing to this union, there's a weirwood tree beyond the wall. Now form up and follow my lead.
Gared, it's good to hear you'll be a ranger.
Thank you.
I know you wanted this.
I'm ready to say my vows.
I didn't have many friends when I first arrived at Castle Black. Grin and Pip, they'd as sooner see me bloodied in the yard than offer a hand. Now, I'd die for either of them. Our brothers are all we have.
Finn.
Shows you what kind of ripe fools are running this place. I can't believe they made you a ranger. You're not fit for the job.
Like it or not, we're brothers now. Means we're gonna have to get along.
Don't count on it. You wouldn't even be here if you didn't have Snow leading you by the hand the whole way.
Well, people might help you if you weren't such an asshole, Finn.
I wouldn't have to be if you all weren't assholes too. No one around here gives a shit about me. They wouldn't even care if I...
Do you know how many rangers are never heard from again in these parts? And I'm about to become one myself. All alone out here. Wildlings everywhere.
Finn, don't worry. You were born to kill wildlings. That jab you gave me the other day, it fucking hurt.
I suppose you're right.
You want a different assignment, because I hear they need someone to clean the shithouse.
See, that's why I got so fucking mad at you, Gared. You're the closest thing I have to a friend.
You handled that well, Gared. They say the old gods watch us through the weirwoods. More than watch us. They know us. The gods are not forgiving. We brothers have to be. We're here. After this, there's no going back. Now go. Take your vows.
In the eyes of the old gods, the Night's Watch offers you a place beside us. Now say the words for all to hear and embrace us as your own.
Hear my words, and bear witness to my vow. Night gathers, and now my watch begins. It shall not end until my death. I shall take no wife, hold no lands, father no children. I shall wear no crowns, and win no glory. I shall live and die at my post. I am the sword in the darkness. I am the watcher on the walls. I am the shield that guards the realms of men. I pledge my life and honor to the Night's Watch for this night and all the nights to come.
You knelt as boys. Rise now as men of the Night's Watch.
Welcome to your new family, Gared.
Men of the Watch now. Means we get to piss off the wall whenever we want.
Didn't know you needed an excuse to play with yourself, Finn.
Gared, you've got a visitor. Over there.
Well, who is it?
Do I look like your fucking squire?
Don't forget the practice sword.
Uncle Duncan!
Gared! It's good to see you. They told me you were at the Weirwood Tree.
What brings you here?
A business with the Night's Watch. A delivery of Ironwood shields to keep you all out of harm's way. That settles it then?
Aye, the delivery looks in order.
Oh, the gods do grant miracles. You look well, nephew. I'm told you're a ranger now. That's good.
Uncle?
Things aren't going well at Ironrath, Gared.
I know. I heard the news about Ethan.
I wasn't there when it happened. Small mercy, I suppose. Not having to see our lord struck down with such barbarity. But House Forrester is nothing, if not resilient.
I should have been there protecting Ethan. What good am I at the wall?
That's why I'm really here. Do you recall Lord Forrester's last words to you? Just before he died, Gregor's final command, spoken to you in confidence.
He said the North Grove must never be lost.
Indeed. But first, it must be found. I've been reading his journals, scouring the legends for any clue what Lord Forrester knew. I think I've found the answer. He describes a fortification, a protected citadel of sorts, hidden from the world, one filled with great power. It was scattered among his notes. Almost an obsession.
And you think it's north of the wall?
His notes suggest as much. And you must find it, Garrett. The search won't be easy. But you're a Tuttle. Our Lord knew you wouldn't fail him.
I just took the Black Uncle. Swore my allegiance to the Night's Watch. Even if I were to agree, somewhere north of the wall, it's not a lot to go on. How am I supposed to find it?
The first chance you get to head north, take it.
And then?
You leave the Night's Watch behind. Strike out on your own. This is no small request I make. I know that. But there's no other choice.
I agree, Uncle. But how?
A brave answer, Garrett. This will help guide you. I found it hidden in Lord Forrester's strongbox.
What is that?
A page from our Lord's journal. But one he tore out and kept separate. Why? I don't know.
It's a map. To the North Grove.
Aye.
I used to be frightened of weirwood trees. But before I was a man grown, I swear, I actually could hear them whispering sometimes. You said it was a citadel of some kind. Could this be it? No. No, it couldn't be that easy. It's hidden here somewhere. A mammoth? This map's only missing grumpkins and snarks. This can't be real, Uncle. Bloody ice dragon. Gods be good. Now that I would love to see.
This looks familiar.
What is it, Garrett?
Talia gave me this. Before I left.
Oh. Wait. Lord Forrester gave Ethan a similar one as well. Roderick too. I wonder.
Look. There's a clasp.
It must open.
I had no idea this was inside. Another weirwood.
But why?
Maybe it's a key to solving the map. A perfect fit. Maybe it's telling us where to look on the map. Oh, it's the whole map that has to turn.
Aye.
The Werewood's mouth. Uncle, whatever this place is, the North Grove must be near.
There's only one way to find out. Here, take this map. Everything we hold dear may well depend on your success. It's a lot to put on your shoulders.
Uncle, I can't break my vows. I can't do it.
I understand your reluctance. When you left Ironrath, you said you'd serve with honor. You already have. God's watch over you. You're the son I never had.
Let's go, Gared.
I don't know. They're probably like little shards or something.
I hope to never lift one of those again.
Wait, so, like a weapon?
Well, your piss is like any other liquid, I reckon.
Mine's mostly ale.
And if it froze on the way down the wall,
Well, that was rather mysterious. A stranger arrives and you're chatting him up.
Someone said it was your uncle looking for you. Well, what did he want?
Looked like you two had a lot to talk about.
Must have been important to come to Castle Black.
He happened to be nearby. Thought he'd say hello.
This is about the last place anyone would want to visit.
It looked like he gave you something.
It was nothing. Let's go and celebrate.
Already keeping secrets from your brothers, eh?
Gared's right. The wall's gonna melt before we get up there. Come on.
There are so many guests already arriving. And have you seen the wedding decorations they put up in the gardens? So beautiful. You know, we're as lucky as she is. Margaery was but a lady when we were sent to serve at Highgarden. But in just a few days' time, we'll be attending to a queen at a royal feast. Where we're standing, we'll be able to see everyone. And everyone will be able to see us.
We've certainly come a long way, haven't we?
I've been meaning to say what I told you about my family. It means a lot to be able to share that with someone. Someone I can trust.
If handmaidens don't help each other in King's Landing, nobody will.
Thank you, Mira. And you know I'll always help you too. Hold on, look. There he is.
Lord Morgrin?
No, next to him. Lord Tarwick. I don't want to be a handmaiden forever. And this wedding may be the best chance of meeting a husband I'll ever have. I have to go talk to him. Margaery won't notice it for a few minutes longer. Could you make an excuse for me? Please.
Are you sure you know what you're doing, Sarah?
Marjorie's so busy. I can't just wait for her to find a match for me. Please, just don't tell Marjorie.
What are you doing here?
I know I shouldn't be here, but we have to talk.
Look, that night, I don't know what might have happened if you hadn't helped me.
Well, I could say the same to you, Lady Mira. But I came here to warn you. I was down in Fleabottom last night when I overheard a couple of Lannister guards talking about...
Shh!
They already know he's missing, probably dead. They're questioning people, searching for his body. It's not safe.
Please tell me you took care of it.
Of course. I told you I would. No one will know what you did. What? What is it? If we're gonna survive this...
What if they find his knife? I threw it away, and there was blood on it.
Oh, no. You do not want to get caught looking for it. Just don't get in any more trouble. And I'll watch your back. We're in this together now.
You saved my life. I don't even know your name.
It's Tom.
Thank you, Tom.
Don't thank me yet, Lady Mira. There's still a knife out there covered with a dead man's blood. And I don't...
Mira!
My lady.
Really? A tryst in the bushes with that coal boy? Not to say it's wrong, but with all the lords and knights in King's Landing.
Truly, it's nothing, Sarah. He's a friend.
Really? Is that so? Come on. Margaery expects us at the throne room. We don't want to be late.
You can tell me all about this Lord Tarwick on the way.
Well, first of all, his name's Garibald, and he has this really funny accent. He told me the cleverest story about this festival they have where they celebrate.
And I've given the musicians a list of songs to play for Joffrey at the feast. I assume you have no problems with the reigns of Castamere?
I trust you've chosen all the standards. But just to be sure, I'll draw up a list of wedding ballads we favor in Highgarden.
Your Grace, my lady.
Which reminds me, Joffrey will require his Kingsguard close at hand during the feast. I'm afraid we'll have no room for your handmaidens.
But we...
What was that? Do you object? Is that what I heard? If you're going
Your
to
Grace,
speak out of turn, girl...
I...
You should finish what you start.
We do as you command, Your Grace. And we'll spend the feast wherever it pleases you.
You'll spend it mopping the stables, if I please. I asked your handmaiden here at the Iron Throne whom she would serve if forced to choose between yourself and the king. She chose you. Yet now she puts the king first. I'm surprised you'd let such swings of loyalty go unchecked. In any case, it's settled. The King's Guard will stay with Joffrey. Your handmaidens will sit elsewhere.
Of course, Your Grace. Anything for my beloved Joffrey.
Lady Margaery, we may not see eye to eye on everything, but I hope you will at least agree with me that our handmaidens should know their place. And that place is not with my brother, Tyrion.
What did she mean by that? You and Tyrion? What you do reflects on me.
Tyrion... he offered to help my family.
He did? Then surely he expects something in return. Sarah, what do you know of this?
Tyrion approached us, my lady. It was his idea, not Mira's.
I don't care what your intentions were, Mira. You went to a Lannister behind my back. I've only ever tried to help you. Why are you making trouble for me?
Please, Lady Margaery, trust me. I know what I'm doing. I've learned from the best.
I don't have the time or patience for your games, Mira. Right now, I need you both to be my handmaidens, and that's all I need you to be. Let there be no mistake. If I hear of you speaking so much as a word to Tyrion Lannister again, you can go home to your family.
I'm sorry, my lady. I made a mistake. It won't happen again. Please don't send me home.
This can't happen again.
Roderick, it's the Whitehills. They're assembling in the courtyard. They've woken the house. You can't let this go on.
Don't worry, Talia. I'll deal with them.
Hurry. I'll check on Mother. What is this?
It's a parade of dead men if I have my way.
Oh,
What is the meaning of this? I demand to know.
Those are strong words. For a cripple who can't carry a sword.
All of you, show your respect to Gryff Whitehill, fourth-born son of Lord Lud Whitehill and commander of this garrison.
Cocky Roderick, we used to call you. Swinging your prick round, lording it over my family. Now look at you, eh?
Roderick the Ruined.
I hardly recognise you. But the name fits, don't it?
I've had enough of this, Gryff. What are you trying to prove here?
I had to get your attention, didn't I? Always so busy beating your own chest, Roderick. I don't think he gets it.
No, my lord. I don't think he does.
Your brother Ethan didn't get it either.
You bite your tongue.
I am in charge now. And the first thing you need to know is that if I am not happy, no one is happy. So my men are taking over your great hall. That's where we'll quarter from now on.
What? You can't.
You'll have to go through me.
I won't have my men sleeping out in your barn in shit and filth.
I don't care if you're happy or not. You'll quarter where I tell you.
I wasn't fucking asking, Roderick. And what's more, you will treat my men right. I've heard what you've done, and if they're eating wormy bread, then your people better be eating shit off the ground. I'm not here to keep them in line. I'm here to keep you in line.
If your men don't like it here, you can march them back to High Point.
Watch yourself, Roderick.
This is against the King's law. You've no right to make such demands.
I have every right. We're here under the orders of Roose Bolton, Warden of the North. So I will be in your halls. I will be in your courtyard. I will sit on your fucking council and be in your bedchambers if I bloody well please.
You can't do this, little bastard. You can't just do whatever...
We'll do what we were sent here to do.
You're mad, Gryff. This is my house and you will do as I say.
Why should I listen to some cripple with half a face? Now, me and my men will take our place in your hall. Unless you think you and your army can stop me. No, you know better than that. You know where we'll be.
This is outrageous.
Roderick!
You can't go in there.
We can and we will.
Unless you want this all to end right now, eh? I'm the only lord here.
Come on.
Gryff Whitehill, a snot-nosed fourth-born, parading in here like a conquering fucking hero.
It was bad enough when it was just the soldiers.
We can't live with them under our roof, soiling our house.
I know you tried to stop them, my lord. But we can only take this occupation for so long.
Our people will break,
and the way Gryff Whitehill came in...
We can't go to war within our own walls. Whatever we do, we have to be careful.
But Gryff Whitehill isn't the beginning of our troubles, or the end of them. We need to look at all the pieces. Whitehill men aren't just in our house. They've raided our lands, burnt farms, and cut down our trees. All the way from here to High Point.
How do we kill a snake, then? By smashing its head.
Gryff isn't the head. It's his father.
Perhaps. But Gryff is here. We have access to him.
And they have Ryan.